All right, your daily hour with me.
Welcome to the program.
We're on every day. It's 11:30. We turn on the machines. Start talking for an hour.
Bruce is dead.
Yeah, Bruce. Bruce Willis. It's Tuesday, November, and it's election day. Do you guys vote today?
Wait, that was yesterday?
It's today, or it was this day, earlier today.
Isn't the 7th?
It's the 7th?
Or is it the
8th?
It's
not the 8th. I think it's the 8th. It's
oh,
the
8th
on the 8th? Calendar.
Okay.
And it's Cedar's birthday.
Hey, yeah, it's a lot of people. Today's today in the real time, it's a lot of people's birthday. It's November 1st.
And November 1st.
We got 4 birthdays at least here. I mean, there are people that I know. I don't know if they're if we should call them or not.
Viewers.
I mean, one of them is Nora. She's been on the show, so I figured, you know, call her maybe, wish her happy birthday. But then we'd also
Rick Ward.
All right. Well, this isn't this message from John Webster.
Oh yeah.
Rick Ward was John Webster. I'm waiting inside for Jim Cooper. I'm standing on the front end of the bridge if you want to give me a call. So I just went to let you know I'm on the front end of the bridge. So I'm waiting inside for Jim Cooper. He's doing for the State City Council. Give me a call. I'm using my cell phone. I'm not at home right now. So give me a call. Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right, let's call him on his home phone.
All right, John Webster. He's a viewer of the program. He likes to. He's the
He stays up late. Oh, why is it sound so crazy today?
Pretty hot today. We're running to a different VCR today. The other one was acting up, so now we can't see the levels going out to the thing. I'm trying to check myself on the.
Gotta watch the monitors. I can hear it. It's loud.
That's good. I mean, as long as we're not in the red, it's fine, right?
Yes. Yeah,
the red is when it gets crazy. If it gets in the red.
Hello.
Hello.
John.
John Webster.
Yes.
How you doing?
Hey, John. It's the program.
Fine.
Hey, John. So we're calling you. Are you you stay up to this late to watch TV still?
I can't hear you very well.
Hey, you stay up this late to watch TV still?
Oh, yeah.
What's on TV right now?
What?
What's on TV? You watching TV?
Yeah, I'm watching, program on Channel 7. Gal with the red hair.
Oh.
Gal with the red hair? I don't know what the show is. Well. We're doing the show right now, John.
What?
You want to come see the studio sometime?
I've been watching your programs, I watch your Halloween programs and I like them a little bit, but with two microphones.
Yeah.
But I'm glad, John.
It's Halloween,
you'll be
John.
You're talking with regular microphone now. You'll be talking with just one mic now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You'll be talking one mic tonight from last Thursday. Today's the first. Let's go back to the from last. You know, from last week.
Probably the 23rd? 24th?
It's the first, so it will be from last Tuesday.
25th, yes. Yeah, the 25th.
Last Tuesday. It's going to be a crazy
I'll be watching
episode.
I'll be watching that. It'll be the 25th show.
That one has some vulgarity in it.
What?
That one's vulgar. It's going to be crazy. It's a crazy one.
My phone cuts off and on. Cuts off.
It's a crazy episode tonight. That's all. Or last week. Yeah. Hey, do you get any trick or treaters there at your house? At your apartment?
I was out I didn't get any, but I was out. I went up to the governor's mansion and got some. I got a Hershey bar from her, and I had my picture taken.
The governor?
Yep. I went by your place last night.
Oh, to the studio or to the my house?
No, I went by Capitol Way. I went by, you know, where your office was. You have your studio.
Yeah, we weren't here. I think I saw you on the road last night.
I can't hear you.
I think I saw your car. I think I was driving on the freeway. I think I saw you.
Yeah, I was waving signs on the Fort Avenue Bridge yesterday too. Before I went up Capitol Way, I was waving signs at right by Bayview.
What kind of signs?
I was waving signs for Jim Cooper.
Oh yeah, he's a good guy, Jim Cooper.
I was waving signs for him. He's for initiative 183, and I am too.
You vote no on that.
I vote no on 183.
So in a week from now, when this airs on TV, it's gonna be I think the whole election's gonna be over. What do you think about 1183? You think that's gonna happen, or do you think it's gonna not happen?
I hope it gets watered down.
Why is that? Why do you think?
Campaign parties are going to be at the governor's house next Tuesday too. And I'll be there too.
What bad things will happen if 1183 passes? Why do you not want to?
I don't know. I'll have some of the stuff from the Democrat party.
Oh, okay. Well, who do you want to win the mayor thing? I guess you're not a Lacey, but you think Pooster or Butzbum?
Well, it's up in the air for me. I still want Dick Pooster, but...
Yeah, me too.
We'll find out next Tuesday. We'll find out next week.
Yeah.
Hey, John, do you want to come to
some of the campaign parties, the governor house next Tuesday, too.
Oh, yeah. Can anybody go to those?
Next Tuesday, come down to the governor house.
Yeah, can we? Can
I know CCTV will be broadcasting some of the candidates like George Barner and stuff like that. I know CCTV will be out televising next week.
Yeah, do you follow the Olympia elections, John?
Oh yeah, but I didn't have anybody on my I had George Barner, I had the initiatives, and I had the Northeastern School District Northeastern School Board officers.
What do you think? Do you know Democritus? What do you think about Democritus?
He fired the Lacey fire commissioners, and then I had approved for Lacey Fire District.
Do you know Democritus?
I can't hear you because you're talking on a different microphone. I can hear the other person.
Oh yeah. Do you know Democritus? Do you know about Democritus? What do you think of him? He's running for, I think, position 3 on the Olympia City Council against what is his name? Stephen Langer?
Langer, yeah.
I don't know him, but I'm for Steve Langer.
Oh too. Yeah.
If you come down to the governing house next Tuesday.
You think
Tuesday night.
Is that an invite only thing, or can anybody show up to that?
Anybody can show up.
Is there food?
What?
Do they have food there?
Yep, there'll be food there.
Oh, did it? What did they serve?
They'll have a TV, and they'll have radios and everything, and they'll have a computer.
What kind of food do they have?
I don't know.
What kind of food did they have last time?
I don't know.
Okay.
Just come down to the government house tomorrow, next Tuesday.
All right, I'll be there. Hey, John, do you want to come to on the program next Tuesday?
What?
You should come onto the program before you go to the governor's office.
No, I'm going to be waving flames for Jim Cooper.
Oh, okay. Well, how
I
about
got left where he's going to be waving flames. Where he's waving flames, I have a paper. I'll get up and get it, and I'll tell you where he's going to be, like tomorrow, or he's going to be, and stuff like that. I got a schedule. Just wait and see. Just wait and I'll tell you.
Okay.
The news is coming on now, and after the news, I'll be turning to your program pretty soon.
Yes.
In about half an hour.
Half an hour of news.
In 30 minutes, I'll be turning to your program.
All right.
After I watch the news.
Yeah, maybe you can let us know what you think if it's affecting you.
What are you looking at on paper?
He's looking for John Cooper or Jim Cooper's schedule.
Let's see. I got it right here, bro. Let's see. Okay, today he was on Black Lake Boulevard at Cook Point Road today from 7:30 to 9 a.m. Tomorrow, he's going to be waving signs on Harrison and Division from 4:30 to 6. If you want to see us, if you want to see him tomorrow, he'll be on Harrison and Division. He'll be there waving signs. Thursday, he'll be waving signs from 7:30 to 9 a.m. on Lily and Martin Way. And Friday, I won't be helping him. But Friday, he'll be waving signs on the 4th Avenue Bridge from 4:30 to 6. That's coming Friday. Then next Monday, the 7th, he'll be waving signs on the 4th Avenue Bridge from 7:30 to 9 a.m. Then Then on Election Day, he'll be waving signs on Harrison Division from 7:30 to 9. And then Election Day again, he'll be waving signs from 4:30 to 6 on the 4th Avenue Bridge.
So that's all in the past now, right?
Not yet. He has the schedule. I told you the schedule here.
Oh yeah, but yeah, that
like tomorrow he'll be at Harrison Division tomorrow afternoon.
Cool. Thanks, John.
If you want to see him on Harrison Division, he'll be there from 4:30 to 6.
All right. Okay.
Well, okay. Thanks.
Hey, John, that sounds good.
You want to see him tomorrow morning, if you want to see him Thursday, he'll be come out to Lily and Martin Way.
Okay, hey, John, you should come see the studio sometime.
Yeah, you gotta go. Come check it out.
I went by last night when I went up to the governor's mansion.
Oh yeah, but you should schedule a time to come down here when you have some free time. Why don't you call us and then we could get you in here and you can be on the show.
Well, if I'm Come down to the come down by the governor's mansion. Come down to the governor's mansion on the 8th.
All right. Okay, John. Well, I guess we'll talk to you later. Thanks for calling and thanks for leaving messages. You can leave more messages.
Yeah, I left a message. I gave you a call when I was waving signs yesterday on.
Yeah, dude, keep doing that.
That's why we're calling you back.
What?
That's why we're calling you back today. We just listened to it not a moment ago.
Yeah, I was waving signs on the 4th Avenue Bridge with Jim today.
Oh.
All right. Thanks, John. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Okay. Come down to the governor's mansion next Tuesday. All right. 8.
8. Okay. Well, bye-bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.
I always wanted to say, look at this. The colors have cleared themselves up.
Yeah,
see,
they really.
Oh,
the studio's on fire.
No, see the fire.
Oh, God. The switcher is on fire.
It's burning. We're too hot.
God. Turn it down.
It's going to choke me out. Oh, man. Let's get that out of there. Look at this color, though. You see this?
It's all fixed.
So, like, it just, like, fixed
itself. Yeah, this is kind of sepia tone there.
Oh, there. But see? That's a little bit. It's kind of...
Well, it's definitely better than it was before with the whole red side thing.
Yeah. Now that this is blue, but now...
What was up with the episode,
Yeah, it was, like, recovering it. It was, like, this couldn't take being off for a while. It had to, like, warm itself up or something.
I see.
And it's looking... We're looking a lot better than we were in the past. So, thanks, Mike. It healed.
It's looking good, Mike.
Here's the second message.
Hey, Kenny. It's Berd. It's about 5:10 or 5:15 on Tuesday. And, I'm at the camp. And, it's day 15. And,
Whoa.
It's really exciting. So,
days.
I hope you're doing well. And, maybe we can talk sometime soon. I'm kind of pulling into a parking spot right now. I won't ram this car right here. So far, so good. Okay. Don't do this at home, people.
I wonder if...
Okay. Muffler, eat dragon. Yay! Just kidding. I wasn't actually parking my car while leaving a voicemail. Okay,
I didn't even
Yeah, well, I hope you're having a good show. Give a call. Sorry, I haven't picked up the phone last few times you called. And
Is
you're awesome.
Bye. Night owl?
Do they sleep at Occupy? I don't think they sleep, but stand up.
Is he an early bird
or night
owl? We have
to occupy the whole
owl.
Time. Let's find out. What time do you go to bed? What time do you wake up? Berd.
Hey, Kenny.
Hey, Berd, it's Freddy.
Hey, Freddy.
Hey, we're both here. Yeah, Berd. Hey, do you like to go to bed early or late?
You a night owl or you an early bird?
It's pretty varied. It depends.
That's amazing.
I'm resting right now, but I can talk for a little bit.
Are you a night owl or an early bird, though? One of those two.
You have to pick.
Oh, gosh. I'm both.
Both, all right.
You're an early owl.
Convertible.
You're an early
owl.
Yeah,
I can't. Yeah, exactly. I'm early, late,
are you
all of the above.
Are you sleeping at the camp?
I am. I'm in my tent right now.
I feel like tonight has been an especially cold night in terms of the last couple nights. How are you handling it there?
I'm warm and toasty for some reason. I've been warm all day. I've been running around doing stuff, so I didn't get cold, but it is cold. You're right.
Well, hey, Berd, you want to come on the program tomorrow?
Possibly, yeah. What time are you taping?
Before, like, either 3 o'clock or, like, 8 o'clock.
Like, 8 p.m.?
Yeah, or 3 p.m. or earlier. It's not between the hours of like 4 and like not, or 8, 4 and 8. Anytime other than that.
Sure. You got anybody else coming in? Tomorrow's Wednesday.
Yeah, there's nobody on the schedule.
So like 3 p.m.?
3 p.m., yeah?
Yeah, I could do that.
Oh, okay.
Hey, so...
Yeah, I don't know what to talk about, though, but we can figure something out.
I never know what I'm going to talk about, yeah.
Yeah, we have no idea what we're going to talk about today. It just comes to our heads.
Where are you in the show?
I had a... We just did the first commercial break, so we're about 20 minutes in.
Cool.
Talk to me. I was curious about the occupation from last night, and it's like... That's a week ago on air date, but did you guys have any Halloween costumes there at the occupation? Was anyone dressed up?
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, there was a lot of Halloween activity in the camp. We actually had a wedding here.
Oh, I heard about that. Angie officiated it,
yep.
Right?
Yes, that is correct. So, and Angie did a great job.
Some good vows.
So when, yep, it was beautiful. So there was a good crowd, and they all went over to Traditions afterward for a reception, and it was really nice. Yeah, and there was someone walking through the camp who was like holding a boombox that was like playing scary music, like. You know, people laughing, like, and going, ooh, ah, and making scary noises that were, like, creepy and stuff. But the person was really nice. It was weird.
Weird.
So there was no vandals or anything on Halloween? Nobody, you guys didn't get, like, teepeed or anything?
Didn't seem to, no.
Did anyone trick-or-treat down there? Did you guys have candy to hand out to the kids?
Yeah, knocking on the pants.
Not really. Unfortunately, it was kind of lame in that way.
What about the children? Are there children who are living at the camp? Or?
I don't know. I mean, we just didn't really, put it together. I guess.
Are you guys still doing those meetings like the every day, like twice a day?
Yeah, the meetings are happening. The one this evening did not happen. I don't know why exactly. There was a parade that happened, an anti-busking ordinance parade. Apparently it's illegal to busk in downtown Olympia, and so some people came and, like, about 30 or 40 people went off and paraded down 4th Street and... protested the busking ordinance, and that was like right before dinner time, and the meeting happens after dinner time, so, and people were just kind of eating and talking, and we're kind of moving some tents around in the camp, so people just like had dinner and started doing other stuff, and we didn't have a meeting tonight, so... No one really complained, so two meetings a day is too much, you know?
Yeah, it seems like a lot of meetings.
Too much.
Is it the first day that you guys have missed a meeting, or is that
There might have been one missed before or two that I, you know, I'm not really aware of any that have been missed before, so I'm not sure, but this is the first one that I've been here that... Like, I hadn't, you know, I could have been like, okay, let's meet, you know, and I just didn't, I cleaned up the trash instead, so, and there was like a pile of stuff that needed to be organized, so I did that, because it didn't, I want the camp to be tidy.
Yeah, I don't think those meetings are going to promise that much. That sounds good. Well, I guess we'll talk to you tomorrow, Berd. I don't want to get all your stories right now.
Yay!
Okay, Berd, we'll see you tomorrow.
You guys rock.
We'll see you tomorrow at 3
p.m.
Yeah,
you rock, Berd.
You rock, Freddy.
Okay, thanks. Bye-bye.
You rock. Hey, I want to talk about your musical beats and everything.
Musical beats? So,
your feats, your features, and whatever, you know. I want to talk about the Downey Brothers and you know, if y'all are going to come down and play music sometime.
Oh, yeah.
On a sunny day or something.
Well, you guys lost the gazebo.
We can talk about that tomorrow, sorry.
You guys should move back and get the gazebo so you could have the gazebo there. Or build a stage.
Yeah, maybe we could have a show at the gazebo.
You guys should build a
stage
there.
Yeah, you guys. I hear you guys have wood and stuff. You can build a stage, right?
Okay. Yeah, that's a good idea.
I mean, I could. I would like to do a show maybe right on the water. If they've got the...
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I feel like I should be in a more guest situation to talk about that kind of thing.
Yeah, right.
I feel like today I'm feeling
like a
producer.
That would be an awesome backdrop.
Yeah, right?
Yeah, we could figure something out. Yep.
Get some videos going.
Totally.
That sounds good.
Totally.
Well, okay, Berd, we'll talk to you tomorrow.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Yeah, Freddie, how's that production end going?
Oh, it's going good. Yeah, dude, the anthology episodes have added a very interesting element to the whole production side, but it's actually going really well, and it's helping me kind of organize and get all of the old episodes in order, which is kind of fun.
Yeah, I think John is watching those. I think John watches. John thinks. I think you're out there. You're probably watching this episode. Yeah, I think you've been watching like all the episodes. You might be like the most dedicated viewer, at least that we know about. So if anybody else, you think that you're watching more episodes than John, you can call in. I mean, you know the drill. I mean, if you're that person, then you've already been watching and not calling anyone. So you're not going to call now anyway.
That's
but
true.
Maybe there's some of you guys out there. Hey, this call is McDonald's. This is one is in West Miffin. Oh, we got to probably call California McDonald's, but we'll call this one in West Miffin, Pennsylvania. Then I think we'll call Cedar.
Oh, yeah, it's his birthday today. Happy birthday, Cedar. That's first order, but we got to get that out of the way before halfway through the program. It's hard to... We don't have the timer. Wait, is that the timer there? Oh, we gotta listen.
I forgot to
5 minutes.
No,
oh, I didn't have to start.
No, it's
been 10:23 for so long.
Yeah, I don't know how that is for this one, so we're just going to have to, I guess, guess.
No, look, it's there on the monitor.
Where? No, that's not it either.
25?
No.
What?
That's that VCR over there.
Oh.
See, so we got this VCR going, and then this one is the one that's...
But, I mean, we had the first commercial break, so that was 20 minutes in. Oh, is that going out onto TV?
Wait, is it? Yeah. No, it's not.
Is it?
I don't know. That might have... No, it didn't stop recording it. I don't think this is going to go out there.
That's not... You're setting the clock there.
Yeah, but I'm trying... Here it is. Box set. Where's the display? I'm trying to find the display settings. What are we doing? Calling him. Oh, McDonald's probably not going to answer today. Nope. McDonald's did not answer. Well, we'll call Cedar.
Yeah, he's in Seattle today.
Hey.
Sounds like we're calling McDonald's, but no, we're calling
Cedar.
It's 1111 today.
Wow.
That's the most ones we could possibly get, except for one.
Yeah, that was 100 years ago.
Is this the Cedar?
Yeah, Cedar
is. Happy birthday!
Thank you! Why are you calling so late?
We're doing the program late time.
Oh, cool. Is this tomorrow or today?
No, this is today.
Oh, okay.
So it's your birthday.
Awesome. Thanks for the birthday wishes.
Yeah. Oh, it's over. It's not your birthday anymore.
Oh, man.
We were trying to do that, though. We were like, man.
Short-lived, but...
We said we got to call you before the thing happened, and it just did, so
yeah,
we made it.
We're halfway through the program now, so it is officially... You've been... However,
24.
Yeah, you've been 24 for a whole day now. How does it feel?
I feel great. I'm glad with my new abilities to fly and see back in time.
Wow.
I think we all have the ability to see back in time.
I can see really far back, like to dinosaurs and stuff.
Oh, whoa.
Whoa.
Yeah, way back.
That's farther back than I can see.
Farther back than most people even suspect is possible.
Impressive. That's great. That's probably the best birthday gift ever.
Yes, thank you. It was all thanks to you, Freddy.
Hey,
well, what's the best Halloween costume you saw, Cedar?
I didn't see any.
You didn't see any costumes?
No, everyone just looked normal to me.
Whoa.
Cedar went as a blind person for Halloween.
What does that look like?
I just closed my eyes the whole time.
Whoa. Hey, see, have you ever... I like this question. This was a Halloween question, but have you ever seen anybody that you thought that they were normal, but later on you found out that they were psychotic and violent?
No.
Oh, that's good.
Thank goodness.
Yeah.
What are you doing right now?
Just partying at John's.
Hey, cool. Good old John.
Yeah. Party time, party o'clock.
At hell yeah, dog owner, John's.
Yep. Of your Daily Hour with Me fame.
Yeah, he's a sponsor too. That's great.
Yeah, he's really supporting the cause.
Yes. Happy birthday, Cedar.
Thank you.
Do you have any goals for this new year?
Yeah, birthday resolutions.
I mean, do they do that?
Yeah, I want to get at least one job this year.
Hey, cool. Yeah,
that's a good goal.
I believe that you can do it.
All right, thank you.
I don't know what you can do at 24. When you're 25, you can rent a car, but when you're 24, nothing much happens.
You just get older. That's all you get.
Well, start preparing for your trip for when you turn 25 to rent a car.
You can rent your favorite car.
Okay, I'm going to get the nice exact car I have. I hope they have one in stock.
Then you can have two of them, at least as one's a rental, but that's fine.
Yeah, it's temporary. For temporary time, you want it.
Is there anybody else around you that, is in, like, is John...
I don't know. They're all doing what people do at parties and, you know...
Talking.
Yeah, involved.
Hanging out. Sitting around.
Yeah. Right.
That's good.
Dancing.
That's cool.
I'm mostly playing with those guys.
You seen anything interesting today on the streets?
Yes, I saw so many cool hedges today on the walk from Capitol Hill down to the waterfront here.
Whoa.
Some exquisitely trimmed hedges.
Ooh.
Were they in shapes?
I saw this hedge... What?
Yes, go on.
I saw this hedge where there's a fence. You know, people have fences and they put hedges behind them and the hedge overtakes the fence and you can't see the fence anymore?
Oh, yeah.
These hedges were trimmed so that the fence was exactly flush with the edge of the hedge. And the hedge went around it and it went into all the little curves, but it was, like, trimmed, like, branch by branch to be perfectly outlined by the hedge.
Wow.
That was pretty cool. I don't know how they even did it. I was very, very impressed.
Yeah, good hedge trimming is an art form, really. I think it's an unappreciated art form, but it really adds a lot.
It's like sculpting.
Yeah, it really does. They're all very traditional, but also very, very thorough and linear and well cut.
Tall as well. I think that if I could categorize the Capitol Hill hedges, it would be tall.
I think that's fair. They are tall.
Okay, well, I guess we'll talk to you later, Cedar. Thanks for having your birthday.
I love you.
All right, happy
birthday.
Thanks
for being you.
All right, thanks. You too.
I do.
Okay, bye-bye.
All right.
Okay, there he goes. Well, now we'll call Rob, because Rob was supposed to be here today, but he ditched out.
Which Rob is this?
Not
Robert Camp?
No, this is, Paranoid, drunk, alien Rob.
That sounds a lot more interesting.
We used to call this guy on the we called him on the radio show.
Oh, wow.
I've called him here, and we've been talking to him every once in a while, but now he's back in town.
Oh, cool.
He's
visiting
here, but he's...
Does he know about the anthology shows playing? I guess that's the radio show, though. We didn't do the radio show.
He probably doesn't want to be on the program because he's kind of paranoid and freaked out by everything. And he's also often too drunk to do anything. So I've been trying to get him on. Every time I call him, he's drunk. So he agreed to come on, but then I didn't actually think he was going to come.
I see.
But we're still going to try to get him on, and he doesn't watch the show. So he won't know what's happening. But one time he told us that last time we talked to him, he had stayed home, and he left town because he lost his job because he was drunk. But he just didn't go to work. But he's probably not going to answer now because he knows that he's missing.
He knows. MIA, Rob. You're MIA today. You're not going to watch this, but we know that you're not here.
And he agreed to be on the program kind of like a little bit before, but I think he was just saying that he would schedule it himself. And I was like, come on, Rob.
Come on, do it.
Because he'd be a good guest, but he'd be freaked out too.
Yeah.
It's kind of like...
I feel like maybe the paranoid viewers maybe out there should know that if you feel uncomfortable at being on TV with your real name and all of that stuff, like, that's okay. We're not gonna
say your name on TV.
Exactly.
Like Mr. Ginsu.
You have an anonymous confession? Call in and say you have an anonymous confession. We won't say your name.
Yeah, just say it's anonymous, and then we won't know who you are. And then we could also call you back, and it could be just your voice, or you can, even if you get one of that, you can get a voice disguiser, or just talk in a like really high pitched voice.
They do have really good voice disguisers at your local toy store or whatever.
Yeah, and Halloween is over, so you can get some of those Halloween ones maybe for cheap.
It might be too late now, but I know that the Halloween stores have, like, they're doing their big clearance thing.
Yeah, 50% off today.
I don't know how long that's going to go, but...
Or you could just whisper. I think whispering is a good way to disguise your voice.
Hey, I had another production news. Oh, yeah, whispering. Hey, I had another production news.
I have a confession.
Yeah. I need to tell you something. Everyone sounds the same when they're... It's good. It's like the secret.
So with the mics, it sounds like we're right in your ear, too. See?
I'm right in your ear. I'm talking to you. Hey, listen. I have a secret for you.
So what's the production...
Next Monday, possibly we could do it from from TCTV Studios, because Dan Bennett is scheduling the studio class for TCTV, and they don't have any actual production to do next Monday, and so he was asking me whether or not we could do the show at TCTV.
Oh yeah, for Monday for Dan?
Yeah, so maybe you might want to give him a call and see what he has to do.
Okay, that sounds fun though. I like to be part of TCTV thing. We're gonna call Dan. I guess for you to take a little break, we're gonna call Dan and ask him about this thing for Monday. Bonjour, my darlings.
Bonjour, my darlings.
Hey, Dan, it's the program. Are you home? Answer your phone. If you're not home, we had a question about that thing next Monday. Apparently, you want to do something at TCTV for the program.
That's hey.
Oh. Hey, Dan, how you doing?
Good. How are you?
Just fine. Freddy's here, and he said that you wanted to do some special event next Monday.
Well, okay, here's the deal. I'm teaching a class. I have 15 students, and I don't have a production for them to shoot. And I talked to Vaughn about doing a senior show, but he was hesitant because he didn't know if he could get enough guests and organize something so quickly, because it's less than a week.
I would love to do that on the program. Let's have the program at TCTV.
To commercial break.
Can you wait a minute, Dan?
Yes, I can.
Okay. All of our
time immersed in the internet, our computer monitor becomes an extension of our consciousness.
An extension.
We act like It's not true, but it is.
It is.
You start to realize it becomes harder and harder
to function.
To function.
YDHWM. YDHWM. Every night, 11:30 p.m.
Let's hear the letters of the title of the show. It makes your life better. It makes your life better.
YDHWM.
YDHWM.
YDHWM. Every night, 11:30 p.m.
Your daily hour with me.
YDHWM.
Hour with me.
Let's hear the letters of the title of the show.
Where, what?
These are
the letters of the title of the show.
How are you guys doing?
We're still doing great, Dan.
Yep, so what's going still on? Good. Still good, Dan.
What's going on with the thing on Monday?
Okay, so essentially the class people, the people in the class, arrive at 5:30-ish. So, I don't know if it's booked yet, if the time slot is booked, but it's on a Monday, which actually kind of works out.
Yeah. It is your show, which
I
so...
I might be working.
Oh.
Well, I can show up briefly from time to time on
Wait,
the show.
No, did you? He might be working. Possibly.
I am working. I'm teaching the class.
I might be working.
Rick might be working.
Oh, crap.
We'll find out, though.
Well, crap.
Well, if it's not, you, why not just shoot another talk show? That's exactly the thing. Like, just tell one of those people in the class to talk. That's what you can do for a test class, but... I might not be working potentially, but I think I most likely will be actually because I've been working 5 o'clock on Fridays.
Okay.
Like Monday?
Or Mondays, I mean, yeah.
Oh. Monday, yeah. Yeah, both you and I, Kenny, we've had to run off to work, you know, right after the show like a few times, so it's entirely possible.
Yeah.
And, you know, my thought was that I would just ask and see if...
I would like to, but it I might not be able to.
Yeah, it wouldn't be a live shoot, of course, but it would be some real practice and stuff. So,
would they? They would have to do Hyper Live, though. They would prepare for the Hyper Live show.
Yeah, no restarts. You just got to go for it.
That's
Start
right.
the background tape and keep on going.
Yeah, and, you know, my thought is that Depp would object because, you know, I don't want them, blah, 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 blah. It's got to be all professional and
but,
stuff.
Wait, I mean, but other shows do it, like Vaudeville. He's not, that the South Sound Seniors is not some kind of a TCTV-sponsored event, right?
Correct.
And
that's
then,
his own thing.
But it's still used for classes. So, I mean, I bet you wouldn't object. There's no difference between this show and Bob's show.
The whole idea is for the students to get practice switching and doing camera and different soundboard and stuff and to switch around and mix it up and just get used to the studio equipment. That's the whole idea. And it doesn't really matter what the show is. It just matters that they get practice doing something.
Totally.
That actually goes out on the station.
And we could even like I know that with most of those kind of class situations, everybody switches jobs, right? They switch from one job to another. And then we could do that during the commercial breaks. It'd be the perfect time.
Yeah. Oh,
and,
yeah.
And, I mean, I've always said, maybe you've heard me say this before, but I think that if somebody can do your daily hour with me, you know, direct your daily hour with me or work on your daily hour with me, they can do any show, you know, because this asks a lot.
Yeah, on the fly.
Yep, that's the whole idea. Well, I guess, Kenny, see if you can get that night off, and if you can't, I'll have him do something.
Yeah, I'll try.
Something. Yeah, and if you can't, it's no big deal. And like I said, I asked Vaude, and he may or may not be able to, you know, have something. I'll know tomorrow, actually, whether or not
he can get a senior show together. And it's earlier than what he wanted, because normally it would be like 2 or 3 weeks from now.
So. Yeah. Okay. Well, okay. That sounds good, Dan. We'll talk to you about this I'll call you back on the show, and we'll see if this is going to happen. And we'll see you next Monday. Yeah. Either way, probably.
Yeah. Hey, thank you for calling.
Thank you, Dan. Okay. Bye-bye.
Okay. Have a good night. Have a good show.
Hey, bye.
Bye.
There it goes.
That was Dan Bennett.
They might be able to give me money. I was like, I've been having Tuesdays off, so maybe I can just say, can I have a Monday instead of a Tuesday?
Mm-hmm. And by working at TCTV, I had some prior knowledge of this. You mentioned it to me. And conceivably, I also talked to my uncle, who, even though he told you not to call, actually wants to come back on the show
yes.
sometime with me. And he might be able to come on Monday if you can do it.
Oh, that would be good. That would be very good. That would be double time, man. I gotta get off. Gotta get both the Dans to meet each other.
Oh yeah, Dan and Dan. I've always wanted to see that happen.
You got
really.
Dan Bennett, Dan, and there's Dan Avery now, and Dan Summer, Dan.
Oh my God, all four of them are such different Dans.
But they're I guess they're all dudes. That's called
all
Dans. Dan.
They're all dudes.
We could get a Danielle.
Yeah, if your name is Danielle, call this number, 330-536-3802.
I wonder if anybody's calling the other number, too. Well, here, let's call McDonald's in California because they're in the same time zone as us.
Right.
And then this way they will answer.
We really need... Sometime we just need to log into Skype.
There were no
the
McDonald's
Google Voice
down
thing.
In California.
Just add that Skype number to the Google Voice thing.
Will it... Can it pick up calls, though?
Yeah, that's... I mean, it'll pick up voicemails anyway.
Okay.
But that... the machine we're running... The program through right now doesn't have Skype, so we just need to do it from a computer that has Skype.
Well, here we go. Then calls McDonald's. Probably about, put it, should have reset the times. About 10 minutes left in the show. Getting down to the end of the show here. They have the pumpkin pies. Probably. Most of the McDonald's have them. Pretty late now, though, but
well, we're going to start seeing them decline now. It's not October anymore, so pretty soon we're going to find out the ones that had the pumpkin pies don't have them anymore.
The holiday pies, the holiday custard pies.
Yeah.
Those are kind of weird. I had them last year. It's a holiday custard. It's a vanilla custard, but it's orange color, so when you ask them, it's like orange custard, but then I say, like, orange flavored or orange colored? And then they say orange colored, and then I say, what flavor is it? And some people, they get confused because vanilla, it's vanilla flavored, but they're like, it's like nothing flavored, it's like sugar or something, right?
Cause what?
Because vanilla is like the most like raw flavored thing. Like, you know, it's like yellow frosting flavored or something. Cause
I think that vanilla harvesters might disagree with that, like, have you heard of this? Maybe I heard it on NPR or some other believable news source, but they were talking about the people who harvest vanilla as the plant.
Yeah, the beans.
Yeah, and then apparently they really don't like the smell of it. Like, we always think of vanilla as sort of this, like, neutral, like, vanilla ice cream is just, like, not a flavor of ice cream. It's just...
It's, like, base flavor.
Ice cream. It's, like... If you get ice cream and it doesn't have a flavor, it's probably vanilla. But for them, they deal with it every day, and it's sort of like they don't like it. So like vanilla flavored body wash, you know, they're like, ew, that smells like work.
That's
McDonald's
has a song. Oh, McDonald's, do you guys have the pumpkin pies?
Yes, we do.
Oh, you do? That's great. Do you know when the next pies are gonna come in?
Cherry.
Yeah. Do you know? You guys are gonna get those back soon, or?
Let me see. Yes, we did. We are going to be receiving cherry pies. Looks like tomorrow.
And there's gonna be no more. Are you gonna take the pumpkin pies out at that time?
No, we'll be carrying out three.
Oh, okay. Oh, that sounds great. Maybe I'm gonna come in and get three pies.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Three pies.
What is that? Yeah.
I wanted to ask her what that was, the beeping noise.
Oh, yeah, I should have asked her, but that's, like, constantly happening. wherever she is, and you like stop listening to it.
Yeah, that's yeah. Tuned it out. I don't think I could tune that out. That's a pretty harsh noise.
It's like if your smoke alarms they start running out of batteries, they start beeping every 10 minutes. And sometimes you go into a place and then it'll beep, and they're like, "What's that beeping?" And they're like, "What beeping?"
Oh my god! What is that? McDonald's on fire? I mean, that's a smoke alarm.
Yeah, maybe we should call them back and be like, "Your McDonald's sounds like it's on fire." Yeah, if the McDonald's did catch on fire, they probably wouldn't even notice because that beeping is happening so much.
Yeah. We could ask. You could call them back about and see if it's still happening, and I'll ask about the shakes.
The same people, and then you're gonna ask them.
Yes.
I think they're gonna.
You think they have caller ID?
I don't want to call the same one back twice in a row. All
right. All right.
They're gonna be.
Yeah, that's.
It'll cause them to be confused, and they maybe they won't think they're doing their job.
We really. Oh yeah.
It may happen though.
Do you have Nora's number? Technically, it was her birthday a week ago today.
Are they
for the viewers
sleeping?
I mean, if it's your birthday, you don't go to bed, right?
Nora. Oh yeah. No. Well, maybe it's on this on up here. Is it?
Noah. I don't think that's a real Noah anyway.
Yeah, we got fake Noah and not Lewis. These are the no numbers.
All the N's are negative. Negative contacts. Don't call the ends.
N-O. No, oh yeah. The one, if you type in no, it says things not to call. Yeah.
Don't call Noah. Don't call fake Noah. Don't call not Lewis.
We've got some of these other numbers. Who else's birthday is it? You had the big list, right?
Yeah. Ashley Calhoun. It's her birthday today.
You want to call your friends? And
yeah, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, whatever. It's better than me just not saying anything.
Whenever I see it
on Facebook, I'm like, I'm not going to say happy birthday on the Facebook.
Yeah,
that's stupid.
This is
stupid.
On TV. This is a big birthday time.
Yeah.
If you guys want to have your birthdays on the show, you can call in a week early, or you can announce stuff. If you guys have any announcements, call in. Then it has to be a week early, though, because we air a week late, or even a year late. So if you have something that's going to happen next year,
let's see if that is that.
So if any of you guys are watching this in 2012, remember the past year? We're now. If you guys are watching this minute's anthology.
Oh, wow, yeah. That's the weird thing is that it... Oh, this is...
One other thing about that anthology is that we're playing them not a week ahead of time.
Right.
So that... Uh-oh. That was not loose. So that now we're... When we say... We're celebrating like the holidays on the show a week early.
Right.
Because that's what we did...
The year before. So I think that's part of the appeal of the anthology. But, I mean, if we... I mean, even if we talk to... No, now. Now if we talk to these people on their birthdays in a year, it'll be on the right day. It'll air on the right day. So...
Watch it next year.
Yeah, we have to... It's the new layer. We have to start thinking about the people.
If you're watching it at 2 a.m., yeah.
Yeah.
Or also in the indefinite future. Like, you guys are going to be watching those up to that. I feel like what happened in the far-off future. That's what I was saying, like, way before. Like, in 20 years...
I really look up to those people, especially.
For you people in the future who have to watch every episode in a row.
The marathoners.
Yeah.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message.
Make sure it doesn't say your number.
7-0.
Yeah.
6.
Gotta get a real message, guys.
To leave a callback number, press 5.
Hey, Ashley, it's Freddy. I was calling to wish you a happy birthday. You're on your daily hour with me. We're calling on the 1st of November, and it's your birthday. Happy birthday. Hope you're having a good birthday. And, yeah, call back 330-536-3802 if it's in the next probably like 10 minutes. I think we've only got a little bit left on the show. But, yeah, I hope you're having a great birthday. Hope you have many, many more. Talk to you later.
Happy birthday. Yeah. All right. Well, that was the birthday time. We did Cedar's birthday. We might have done something with Dan here. Figured out some production stuff. Oh, I guess it's a new month. We're going to start on new, try to get a new background tape maybe.
Oh, we really should.
I want to get a clock.
Honestly, I want to get 3 background tapes with different commercials, intros, and outros.
Oh, right.
And then you could just...
Oh.
Just pick a different one whenever you want.
Do we have more commercials?
No.
We gotta get some. We can leave this tape as one of them, but we could probably put the clock on there too. Maybe we should just take this tape and
get a clock on the tape or clock on the.
Oh yeah, if we just got a clock, that would be.
Is that what you mean, or?
I was thinking get a clock on the tape.
We could get a, like instead of the logo maybe.
Yeah, or maybe it's like, all the clock would have to be is like a circle. Like
oh.
Like a circle with like a dot, like one dot on the circle, and then the
it
dot
moves around.
So it's just like a very small clock thing.
Yeah.
So it just moves around slowly, watch it go. Maybe that's like
maybe that
seconds.
Should be the new logo, you know.
Oh, the logo with
YDHWM, and then there's a circle inside of it that moves around with a dot.
So that it does both, yeah.
I mean, that way it'd be unobtrusive. Like, I feel like if we had like a big clock somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, all we would need to do is turn the thing into a circle, with like a ring on the outside with a little dot.
I was also thinking that you could have a real clock. Like on the wall or something.
Yeah.
So then the viewers out there could see as we filmed the program. I mean, if they care. I don't know if the viewers care.
That's what
care
we
about
used to that. Do. We used to have clock cam.
Clock cam, though, was notoriously hard to actually comprehend. It was upside down sometimes or sideways. It was a square clock with no actual numbers on it.
That was bad. I still use that clock, but now I haven't touched it. It's sitting back in the old studio.
The Apple clock.
It never functioned.
Cam?
I bought that.
Oh.
I bought that clock for $1 at the Goodwill, and I put a battery in it. And never worked once.
Too bad. It's good. It's a nice looking clock.
Yeah. So maybe we get. We should just get a clock. We can just get a real clock. Put it back here. So you guys have a clock and just keep going those Goodwills. But I think the clock on the tape would be good too, because it'll be small. And
I meant
to
the clock on
that.
The tape. It's a good idea.
We could do both, and you can watch how they line up. I don't know if you guys are going to do that on the thing.
Well, the games you can play on the program. Lots of games on the program if you want to play them.
For the future here, we got Berd tomorrow at 3. Then Reese on Thursday if he shows up, which he almost never does. Well, maybe Reese is going to be here. And then Friday, we don't have anybody scheduled for Friday.
That's another one of the games in the program is the guest going to show up?
Yeah.
It's a pretty good game. We got Duck Hugger on the 11th, Angie on the 10th. Oh, but that's
next
week.
Brown on the 8th, and then Scott Doolin with Lewis on Saturday, and then the return of Sean Downey after a couple weeks on Sunday there.
The wild return, yeah. He lost his most recent episode was Lost Forever.
Oh, yeah, so.
He's been gone for like 3 weeks now.
Wow, that's a month.
It's a long time.
Or actually, how many weeks are in a month? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 weeks?
Hey, 1 minute
four
left.
Weeks? 4 weeks, maybe. 1 minute left of the show. You know, so we did it again. Started the show. Wasn't sure what we were going to do today. Didn't know if we were going to make it through the whole time. And, yeah, here we are again at the end of another episode. We've gotten all the way through the hour, and we didn't lose consciousness.
I'm still awake.
So, What number are we on now?
Wait, look on the calendar. We got an internal calendar now.
Oh yeah,
I think it's like 4:10, 4:11, 4:12. Click on the thing that says calendar there on the.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
It
and
is.
It's one more than whatever that says.
4:10 is or 4.
So it's 4:11. Oh wait, 4:09.
4:09. 409 episodes, everybody. Thanks for watching them all.
Yep. There was that big story.
It looks like we're out of time in the world. It's a good thing we have forever. Thanks, crew. You guys want to be on the crew? You don't do anything. You just get on this crew right there. Thanks, viewers.
You guys are viewers. Calls. You can. Thanks for watching the show. Thanks, TCTV. Thanks, LeBebe. Hell yeah, dog. Hell yeah. All right, everybody. Thanks for watching. Tune in tomorrow for Berd. Bye bye.